If you come to the UK for the first time, you may be surprised that people don't speak the same as the recordings in your English language textbook. English, like every other language, exhibits variation. People speak with different accents.
Actually, being a proper Scottish guy, I'm not bothered about the rain.
No one ever told me to shut up.
So we had to get out to Vancouver early.
If you're aware of how people speak differently, you'll find it easier to understand a wider range of native English speakers. To help, I've made a three-part video series exploring the phonetic diversity across the UK's four nations: England, Wales, Scotland, and Northern Ireland. This video is about consonants. The next will be on vowels, and the final video will focus on sounds characteristic of certain accents. Let's get started by focusing on five consonant features that distinguish UK accents: rhoticity, H-dropping, glottal stops, the TH sounds, and the NG sound.
There's a pub around the corner.
Rhoticity deals with R sounds. Rhotic speakers will always pronounce the letter R as R. For example, Rory's partner. Here there are four R sounds. Rory's partner. Non-rhotic speakers only pronounce the letter R as R when there is a vowel sound afterwards. For example, Rory's partner. Here there are no R sounds in the second word. Rory's partner. We find rhotic speakers, those who always pronounce the R, in Scotland, Northern Ireland, and South West England.
That was lovely, just being in my car. You couldn't get me. Just being in my car.
Has been given this opportunity to meet her birth mother.
Has been given this opportunity to meet her birth mother.
So we had to get out to Vancouver early because she couldn't fly after a certain date.
The two main parties are in power.
Who is the worst possible person?
It's got to be annoying having a younger sister who's more popular than you, hasn't it?
I was born in the southern part of England, and you'll hear that my accent is non-rhotic. I only pronounce the letter R if there's a vowel sound afterwards. Most speakers in England and Wales are non-rhotic.
Being together, working together is just such a good laugh.
I worked in LA for the first time last year.
So for the next couple of weeks, I thought that I'd discovered Shakespeare.
I liked how much humour there was, how much warmth there was.
As we go on this journey, we're not expecting to fall in love.
This is a map produced by the University of Cambridge in 2016. Orange marks areas where there are more rhotic speakers, green where there are more non-rhotic speakers, and yellow where there is roughly an equal mix of both. It's true that we find rhotic speakers in Scotland, but we also find non-rhotic speakers there too. Linguists have documented non-rhotic speakers in Scotland since the 1970s. In southwest England, the situation has changed significantly in recent times. When a survey was conducted in the 1950s, this area was strongly rhotic. But nowadays, there are far fewer rhotic speakers here. If you're travelling within the UK, then expect to hear both rhotic and non-rhotic speech. You may have heard of received pronunciation, or RP. Different people have different definitions of what RP refers to, but for many it describes an old-fashioned English accent.
That's why it's even more important to tackle this issue.
In this video series, I'm going to refer to the modern successor of RP called Standard Southern British English, or SSBE. I'm speaking in this accent now, and you'll find lots of people with this accent throughout the south of England. SSBE is a non-rhotic accent.
Have a cup of tea, and I think about leaving the house.
In some accents, the sound is always pronounced at the start of sentences or stressed syllables, like hair, here, behind. In other accents, this sound is dropped. Air, ear, behind. This is known as H dropping. The H sound is pronounced by speakers of SSBE and people in Scotland and Northern Ireland.
I was really apprehensive about how I was gonna...
He was like sort of hugging me. I had this time out moment.
Haggis is delicious. Have you tasted haggis?
I'm not a huge fan of horror films either.
I could see hundreds and hundreds of windows.
And it's really heartbreaking. It just didn't occur to them that would happen.
But many speakers in England and Wales drop this H sound.
I've always had long hair.
He said, I've just caught two of them running up the street laughing because all the houses are stuck together.
I would like to at some point, but I haven't even been home, so I haven't even spoken to work.
Obviously, we go back out there this weekend and hopefully we can return the favour.
When you're hungry, you're hungry. That's all you care about is the actual food.
He did grow on me. He had to plaster the house.
So how dare you? How dare you try and control that?
I made the job hard for myself, really, because I thought when I come in here, I want to bring back a bit of the East End.
H droppers may not be consistent in their H dropping. For example, somebody may pronounce a word with H. And later pronounce the same word without the H. For these speakers, the H is variable.
Big West Ham fan.
They really helped build this film.
Rebuild this country, please come and help.
If you're in England or Wales, then expect to hear words pronounced with and without H.
Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip.
A glottal stop is made when the vocal folds inside the larynx or voice box firmly come together for a short period of time. It sounds like an abrupt pause. For example, if I replace the t sound in better with a glottal stop, it becomes better. Better. Glottal stops are often used to replace a t sound at the end of a word in many accents across England, Wales and Scotland.
You know, played a little bit less.
When I watched that, I'm thinking, gosh.
No, it was a stage where I thought, right.
Jeremy got much more balanced coverage.
Even members of the royal family use glottal stops.
All that kind of stuff, you know, with that, that comes for the job.
I'm average, I say, I'm not brilliant.
Glottal stops are also used to replace a t sound between vowels. It's perceived negatively by some people, but it's normal for many in England, Wales and Scotland.
Nature is a very important part of feeling okay.
No one ever told me to shut up.
Especially to see them getting on.
If I said that I liked anything on Twitter.
We would all have matching tattoos on our ankles.
Actually, being a proper Scottish guy, I'm not bothered about the rain.
I think also putting myself in their shoes.
If you're in England, Wales or Scotland, you might hear a t sound being replaced by a glottal stop. There are two th sounds in English, th and th. They're made with the tongue touching the teeth. Linguists call them dental fricatives.
Hugged him from behind like this and just like, thank you.
There was a man with a pig's head on. There was a man with bandages all around him.
More and more speakers around the UK pronounce these TH sounds as an F or V sound instead. These sounds are made with the lower lip touching the upper teeth.
We're both beautiful.
He's got a good job and he's a northerner, so he should have good banter.
I'm not blessed with handling skills.
Fit and healthy at the moment.
It bothers me because what makes London great.
At the start of a word, th is sometimes replaced by d, particularly by some speakers in London.
There's a bit of that.
They are from my area. I see them all the time.
Most speakers in the UK do not pronounce a g sound in words ending ng, like sing and song. There's still no g if a suffix is added. Singer, songs, singing.
He would sing songs and recite poems and
I'm such a bad singer. Please don't make me do this. I'm such a fan singer. Please don't make me do this.
Thanks for singing and dancing. Thanks for singing and dancing.
But in the Midlands and the north of England, some speakers will pronounce a g. For example, singer, rather than singer.
Just before I went on to sing. Just before I went on to sing.
When you're on the tube and like you've got a song in and you're looking around and you're like,
when you're on the tube and like you've got a song in and you're looking around and you're like,
you get teams that will literally have a winger stand on your toes. Have a winger stand on your toes.
Well, my mum is a singer, my stepdad is a bass player. Well, my mum is a singer, my stepdad is a bass player.
Or bringing new recruitment departments. Or bringing new recruitment departments.
When you're singing.
Speakers in different parts of the UK use different consonant features. There is nothing wrong or right about this, it's just part of normal variation within the language. If you're aware of this phonetic diversity, you'll find it easier to understand native speakers. Expect to hear partner and partner, happy and appy, better and better, think and think, singing and singing. The next time you listen to a native speaker from the UK, see if you can identify some of the features listed in this video. If you're a non-native English speaker and you want to improve your English pronunciation skills, then sign up for my online course. It's tailored to your native language, prioritises sounds that improve your intelligibility, and uses SSBE as its model. Click the link to find out more. Make sure you subscribe and click the notification bell so you know when I release my next video.